The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... I'm E.G. Marshall. You know, a lot of you have been nice enough to write me letters, and a surprising number of them have asked for more Western stories. So, here is another. Back in the frontier life of the 1860s, west of the Mississippi, the horse was still man's means of locomotion, a noble animal, and particularly in those days, a good deal more noble than many a man who rode him.
I brought you some breakfast, Wayne. I figure you and Daddy would be hungry.
Hold it right there, ma'am. Don't even move enough to jiggle them dishes.
Don't go for your gun, Sheriff. The big one has us covered.
That's right. Just don't let anyone try anything foolish or the lady gets it first. Okay, Sheriff, just loosen your gun belt nice and easy and drop it to the floor.
Mystery drama, The Death Trail, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Ian Martin and stars Bob Caliban and Robert Dryden.
It is sponsored in part by Allstate Insurance Companies and Buick Motor Division. I'll be back shortly with Act One.
Transportation of large sums of money in any era is hazardous. At no time more so than through the Wild West, especially in the years after the Civil War. In the late 1860s, $200,000 was an enormous amount of money. So huge, in fact, that the logistics of moving it required planning, secrecy, protection, and at the end, a good deal of misdirection. This story of the Old West begins, appropriately enough, in the sheriff's office in a small Texas town, Crystal City, some 70 miles north of the Mexican border.
So long, Clancy. See you coming back through.
What you got, Hank?
A mail pouch. Kind of light this week, Sheriff.
Can't make me mad that way. Mail brings nothing but trouble these days.
We're just one special here, for the bank.
Oh, get it on over.
Oh, Sheriff, it's addressed personal to Wayne Prescott.
I reckon it would be, since with the exception of Pearlie Dimscott, there ain't nobody else connected with this here branch.
I sure would hate if I had to bring it over.
What kind of deputy are you if you... Oh, on account of Abby.
Well, didn't mean to drag your daughter into this, Sheriff. It's just that... Anytime I can avoid Wayne Prescott, I sure figure to do so.
Well, I'm right sorry, Hank. You're a good boy. Before Wayne blew into Crystal City, I guess maybe Abby felt the same way. But it ain't anything I can rightly handle. Wayne's a good man, too, and Abby's got to make her own choice.
No, I know that, Sheriff. I ain't making no complaint. Only want what's best for Abby, but... Don't make it easier for me to face up to Wayne Prescott anytime, anywhere.
Well, I can't say I blame you, Hank. Now, come on, give me that letter. I'll get on over to Wayne myself. Bring you any trouble there, Wayne?
Well, no, Sheriff, not exactly. A little puzzlement, maybe.
Anything I can help with?
I just don't know. Anyways, looks like you may be sort of party to it if... You and Abby ain't changed your minds about going up on the next coach to San Antonio.
Oh, not so as you'd know it. I got to get a new hammer on my Winchester, and Abby looks to buy herself some linens and cotton and dresses and stuff for... against time. Now, I reckon between the two of you, you have set some sort of date.
More or less, Ab, but... Well, I'm the one who's been holding off.
Oh, how come?
Well, ever since I was sent down to open this branch of the Texas and Frontier Unity Bank, I've had a notion Colonel Chalmers, the president, had something big in mind, and from what this letter says, whatever it is, it's about to bust wide open. I shouldn't even be telling you this much.
Oh, heck, son, I didn't mean to pry.
Well, I'm not trying to hide nothing. I don't know what's cooking, but I do know I'm going to be heading for San Antonio on the next stage with you and Abby. The way this letter reads, something big is brewing. Something just big enough could turn my whole life around.
I don't know what I'm getting myself into. What are we lugging that old wedding trunk of your mother's all the way up to San Antone for?
I won't give you more than one guess.
Honey, I'm a sheriff. How much money do you figure I got stashed away?
Enough for my dowry. Don't you think so, Wayne?
Now, don't you get me involved. As far as I'm concerned, you don't have to bring me nothing but your own sweet self.
Oh, no, sir. If I'm going to live off you the rest of my life, Wayne Prescott, I'm going to bring enough along to start off so you can't ever mean-mouth me.
Don't try no arguing, Wayne. You can't win, boy.
Yeah.
But that big old trunk is...
Just let me do the buying, and it won't break you to fill it up.
Well, that's why you brought that Winchester along?
That isn't mine, Wayne. You know it. It's Dad's.
There still is rough country, Wayne. Comancheros, riff-raff left over from the war, even some renegade Indians, and... I hear tell some of the outlaw gangs are riding again. Had some wanted signs on a couple.
Like who?
Oh, the Ferry Brothers, Black Mike and his crew. There's even word what's left of the Gunnysack Gang may have drifted south.
The Gunnysack Gang?
Oh, that was way before your time, honey, and the war.
Yeah, I've heard of them.
Who were they?
Killers. Some said they was brothers. Who knew? Everything they pulled, bank robberies, holdups, raids on helpless people, even train jobs. They wore gunny sacks or flour sacks over their heads with holes cut out for the eyes.
Weren't they ever caught?
No, sir. Sometime during the war, they kind of disappeared.
How come, Sheriff?
Well, nobody knows for sure. They hit a bank up Grant Bluff's way, and in the shootout, one of them was hurt pretty bad, according to everybody who's seen it. Some figured he was the leader. He must have died. So, that broke him up.
And the one that was shot, wouldn't he have had to go to a doctor or something?
Well, maybe he just died and they buried him. Anyhow, they dropped Sheriff out of sight when the war was all. There's a power of outlaws abroad. More than ever, it seems to me, as a lawman during these Reconstruction days.
Oh, Daddy, don't be so gloomy. It's supposed to be a kind of pre-honeymoon trip for me. So I didn't expect to have Wayne along with me.
Now, don't think it isn't an unexpected pleasure, honey. But I can't promise you you're going to see too much of me.
That boss of yours sounds like a mean old bear. I hope he has nothing up his sleeves going to interfere with our plans.
Well, I don't see how he can.
Well, sir, whatever he has, you're going to know right soon. We're coming into San Antone now. Wayne, boy. Glad to see you.
Hello, Colonel. I'm sorry to find you in bed, sir.
It's only temporary. My old wound acting up. Don't you ever get any twinges from yours?
Well, I guess I got out lucky, sir.
I owe you my life. You know, I'll never forget that.
Well, I owe you the one I'm living, sir. I ain't likely to overlook that.
You a good banker, Wayne?
I don't know, sir. All I know is what you taught me.
If I touch you right, that you do. You ever wonder why I dealt you off into this godforsaken spot you've been sitting in the last 6 months?
Oh, maybe. But I learned to take orders in the Army.
Yeah, you're made for better than that, Wayne. You went because I asked you to.
Yes, sir, you could say that.
To learn this country like the back of your hands.
Yes, sir. But why?
Well, because I saw something big coming, son. And it's here now. You ever hear tell of a man named McCoy?
He got a first name?
Joseph.
I don't recall him.
Yeah, well, he just bought a town in Texas named Abilene. Know where it is?
Yeah, about the middle of the state, 200-300 miles north of here.
Right. Maybe 600-700 miles south of a stockyard he's setting up in Kansas, right next to the railroad. He plans to slaughter beef there ship it east.
Well, yes, Colonel, but I don't see where I fit in this or you.
Now, what does beef on the hoof sell for here in South Texas?
Depending on demand, $2.50, $3.50 a steer.
McCoy plans to plaster the state of Texas with circulars offering $40 a steer delivered to his stockyard. The cattle be assembled at Abilene, driven north on the hoof.
Well, you're still ahead of me.
Now, Wayne, I've taken every cent I have in cash, borrowed, mortgaged. Came down here to comb this state, buy up every head of cattle I can afford. And the men to drive them north. Son, there is a fortune to be made. If we can get in there before McCoy's circulars, buy them at bottom price here.
It's a long drive, sir. If weather, drought, Indians, rustlers, well, who knows what attack your drives, a fortune could be lost.
It's a gamble worth taking. I'm flat on my back. I can't take it. Wayne, will you take it for me?
Well, Colonel, it's a large responsibility.
I'll pay you 10% of all we clear.
If it all goes well.
Son, it can't fail. Just takes a little time is all. Just think of what your percentage would be. Even buying at $4 a head.
How much, sir?
Exactly what I got in that strong box over there. In notes, silver dollars, gold pieces. $200,000.
Double whiskey. Neat. Am I crowding you, mister?
What makes you think so, dude?
I'd like a little room to step up to the bar.
I'll give you room, boy. Outside, we ain't breathing down the back of my head. Ho, ho, ho. Damn me. Wayne, boy. I can't believe it. Why, little brother, I thought you was
up... Hold it, Slim. What are you doing way down here south in San Antonio?
When I tell you, you're purely gonna know why you are one sight for sore eyes.
Watch it. I can't talk here. Where's Bubba?
Over to the fancy house. You know him, pleasure before business.
I don't want to know what you two are up to. But something tells me I got to.
We've been trailing some old dude carrying himself a strong box. We got a notion it's filled with cash money.
You're going to leave him and that box alone.
Well, what's the matter, baby brother? You got religion or something all of a sudden?
I've been through a whole lot since I last seen you and Bubba. But I can't take a chance talking to you here. Where you hold up?
Well, if you're so high and mighty and lily white, I don't rightly know if us poor trash relatives want to see you in case the dirt might rub off.
I told you I can't talk here. Now, where?
Well, if you was to ride out on the road toward the H Bar Q Ranch, you know it?
Yeah.
Just outside of town, there's an old broke-down settler's cabin. We could meet you there. When?
Just as soon as I'm sure the sheriff and me say goodnight.
Sheriff? That the kind of company you keep now?
I'm on the straight, Slim. That's why I never looked you up. I'm even getting married.
Hoo-wee! But if you're on the side of the law, what's the sense of meeting up with us?
Because I got a proposition to make you. Something big. Just might set your feet on the straight and narrow, too.
Well, I just don't see why I had to leave behind my whole trousseau just to fill up my trunk with all that money.
I'm right sorry, Abby, but...
Well, that was my fault, honey. When the colonel called on Sheriff Thomas for an escort for the stage, Chip had nobody to spare. That's how come I got called in.
But I thought you said, Wayne, the colonel had an army escort with him.
Well, he did till he took sick and they had to report back. I wanted you to stay on back in San Antonio, but you were so doggone stubborn.
Yeah, I told Wayne he might just well give in. But just to give us a little extra protection, I figured we didn't want to be seen loading no strong box.
So, like they say in the army, we commandeered your trunk.
Yeah.
I still don't see any need for all that fuss. Nobody knows about the money except us and the colonel, do they?
Well, these days you never can...
What was that?
Somebody hit the man riding shotgun. Trouble.
Plenty. Look ahead at the draw there. Seems like we run right smack into a holdup.
It was St. Paul who said, "The love of money is the root of all evil." And the evil in this case spreads slowly and inevitably, like some noisome growth from a swamp that smothers and chokes everything it touches. I shall return shortly with Act Two. Side of the careening stagecoach, the road dips away. On one side, to a natural arroyo, on the other, a drainage ditch dug to prevent washouts. But even if the driver had wanted to pull up short of the men up ahead, looming like creatures from another world with their heads shrouded in flour sacks, he would have had little chance. For the horses, startled by the first shot, are running out of control against the smoking brakes, the bits between their teeth.
Driver, go through as fast as we can. We'll cover you. How many of them, Wayne?
Just two, as far as I can.
Hell, we outnumber them. Go okay, Abby.
Yes, Daddy, but it's hard to aim the way we're pitching around.
Just keep firing until you empty that magazine.
I got one on my leg.
Ah, you sure did.
Wayne, they're running for cover.
Hit the other one, Wayne.
Damn, missed him.
I'm going to tell the driver to hold up. We'll go after them.
Oh, let him go. Who cares? Everything else came through safe. Let's powder on for home.
Well, there's the Colonel's $200,000 safe and sound.
What's he sending all that money down to Crystal City for, anyhow? I get kind of uneasy of that kind of money lying here in our bank.
And it's in the safe. Only one person's got the combination. Don't you trust me, Sheriff?
Altogether too much money around for a small city like ours.
No one's gonna lift that safe out of here. Took a flat wagon and a crane to bring it in. It ain't gonna be blown open either. Not without dynamite and the money inside, so it won't be no use to nobody. So forget it.
What about those men who tried to stop us today?
That was before the cash and gold was locked up tight. You figure we ought to ride out and look for them?
It don't make no sense. Either that one you hit is picked clean by the buzzards right now, or they just sloped off.
Do you think they really might have been, what you call them, the gunny sack gang?
If they were, then one of them is dead. I only saw two men. And didn't sound like more was fired, huh, Wayne?
Yeah, way it looked to me, sir.
Well, so I guess we can write them off.
Just in case, I'm gonna bunk down here in the bank for the night.
Yeah, just set it out with you.
Oh, it's been a long day. You better get some rest, sir.
Wayne's right, Daddy.
I can take care of myself. Nobody gets in here, I don't let in. And within the next few days, as the plan goes, if I get busy buying, I ain't gonna have no money left to worry about. Just some 50,000 head of steer.
Well, just the same, I think I will bunk down with you. I want to get Hank to see you safe home, Abby.
No use trying to stop him, Wayne. He's just as stubborn as I am.
I never found you that way.
Well, that's because you never asked me a thing I didn't want to do. With all my heart.
Abby. Now, you going home. And you stay there till I come for you again.
Don't you keep me waiting too long.
You better hope I do. I ain't nothing but bad medicine for you now.
What was that?
My game's on rooster. Morning.
Still dark out.
Yeah.
Get some sleep.
Oh, I'd still be pounding my ear if it wasn't for Ma Gaines' old feisty rooster.
Yeah, I guess you's out just as deep as me. You never put out the lamp.
Well, how about that?
Wouldn't think one kerosene lamp burned that long, would you? I tell you what, I'll go fetch us some coffee. Now, you keep this tight shut, you hear?
Don't you worry.
How about that back door?
You couldn't get through that with a battering ram. less than anyone wanted to take down the bar.
Okay, I guess you're all buttoned up. Be sunup time when I get back.
Slim.
It's me, Wayne. I thought you'd never give the signal.
I had to get rid of the sheriff first.
Where's Bubba?
With the horses.
Step inside. Starting to get daylight out. How many horses?
Four. One for each of us, one to pack the money.
You got enough saddlebags?
Yep. Better let me go get them while you open up the safe.
No!
Well, why not?
Because that's not the way it's gonna be done.
We could load up and be out of here within 10 minutes.
Sure. With a posse at our heels, we can't outrun carrying the weight we gotta be.
Well, who's gonna find out till the bank opens? That's enough head start.
The sheriff will be back with some coffee in a minute.
Oh, damn all.
No, that suits me fine.
How come?
Because when he does, you and Bubba are gonna be waiting here. So he's a witness that you forced me at gunpoint to open up that safe. You get the flour sacks? The way we always worked?
Yeah, for me and Bubba, yeah. I won't help you none.
That's the whole point. You're going to take me with you as a hostage so nobody can follow up on us. It's only 35 miles of foothills. Once we get into them, we get lost.
But what happens when you don't come back?
How many hostages do? They'll figure you dry goats me somewhere. So once we get away clean, nobody will be looking for any of us.
That's a long way from the old days. Little old brother was simple then, just grab and run.
The difference is, Slim, I've had a taste of being a solid citizen. And it suits me fine if I got enough money to enjoy it. That's why I had you make that phony attack on the stagecoach. Set myself up to look like a real hero, defending the money and the lady. What I want out of this is to be dead. With nobody trying to trace that, that I ain't dead, you see. Only I'll still be alive and kicking and rich. Now go on now. Go get Bubba and the saddlebags.
Morning, Sheriff.
Morning, Hank.
Everything all right over at the bank?
Oh, yeah. I figured to bring Wayne some coffee. Got any boiling?
Yeah, just started. It'd take a few minutes.
Why don't you go back to the ranch, get yourself some breakfast?
I promised Wayne I'd bring him some coffee.
Oh. I'll take it over.
I wouldn't make you eat crow knowing how you feel. Hey, somebody's coming into town. See who it is.
Yes, sir.
It's a buckboard. Oh, it's Miss Abby. Come to fetch you, I reckon.
That don't make no sense. I got my horse. Open the door, see what's up.
Yes, sir.
Oh, morning, Miss Abby. Where are you headed?
Oh, morning, Hank. I got some hot breakfast here. I hope it's kept warm enough under the cozy.
Oh, for me and the sheriff?
I was taking it to the bank for Dad and Wayne. I didn't think of you.
Oh, yeah, that figures.
Oh, come on, Hank. I didn't know you'd be up yet.
Or care.
Please, Hank. Don't be childish.
I ain't childish. I just don't cotton to your Mr. Prescott. I don't trust him.
Because you're jealous.
Could be. It's only because I want everything right for you. Something tells me he isn't the man to make it that way.
Oh, stuff and nonsense. You want to help me unload?
I wouldn't give him the time of day, let alone carry his victuals to him. You and the sheriff can run after him all you want. You just leave me out of it.
Keep away from that window, Bubba.
I just like to see his sun come up, little bride.
You can see it tomorrow. And don't call me that.
What?
Little brother.
Oh.
Looks like he's grown too big for his boots and his family, Bubba.
Don't be a fool, Slim. But you got to realize we don't know each other, so no names.
Okay. You get that, Bubba?
Yeah. It's just the way he used to be.
Damn.
What is it?
Sheriff coming.
Well, that's what we want.
Yeah, but he's got Abby with him.
Oh, pretty little gal.
Get away from that window, Bubba. Now what do we do?
Well, maybe it's better this way. We take her with us. The sheriff wouldn't dare go after us. He wouldn't risk her life. She can ride the pack horse. We'll divide up the saddlebags. Okay, Slim, get behind the door. Bubba, the other side. Flatten out against the wall.
Yeah.
Let the girl in, Slim, and cover her. Bubba, pull the sheriff in fast and get the door closed. And keep the sheriff and me covered. Okay, hold it. Shh.
It's me and Abby, Wayne. Okay to open up.
Come on in, Abby.
I brought you some breakfast, Wayne. I figured you and Daddy would want
to... Hold it right there, ma'am. Don't even move enough to jiggle them dishes.
Don't go for your gun, Sheriff. The big one has us covered.
Okay, kick that door shut. Lock it. Don't try anything foolish, Sheriff, or the lady gets it first. Just loosen your gun belt nice and easy and drop it to the floor. What's going on here, Wayne?
Now hold up, Sheriff. They want me to open up the safe.
You going to?
You sure better, Sheriff. I'm going to blow him all to hell. Now, you going to open that safe?
Well, sure. Sure, just don't do anything to harm them.
Then get busy.
How'd they get in here?
I knocked on the door. I thought it was you with the coffee.
How you boys expect to get away with this?
Right easy, Sheriff. Just tie you up and gag you.
I'll be after you with a posse in 5 minutes after I get free.
Oh, no, you won't. Because you see, I'm taking a dude here along with us as a hostage. And just in case you don't care enough for his skin, we'll take the little lady, too.
No, by heaven! Papa!
Why, you killed him!
Now, if he acts up anymore, I just might.
Oh.
We don't need him all that much now. He's got the safe door open.
I'm all right, Abby.
When are you going to let them go?
Oh, figure a day's ride across the plains of the foothills. Once we reach them, you'll never find us. We'll let them go then. Now, that's enough talk. Let's all get moving.
Sheriff Benson, you in there?
Yeah.
Sheriff, that you?
Yeah.
Sheriff? Darn difficult to see anything through the window. Wait a minute. Good Lord. Yeah, I'll be right there, Sheriff, as soon as I can get through this glass. Hold it. I'll get the gag off. Who gagged and hogtied you, Wayne Prescott?
What makes you say that?
Well, I just seen him and Miss Abby riding out of town with two fellas who had flour sacks over their heads. I come a-running to get my horse and you and take out after them. I knew something had gone wrong. When I didn't find you at the office, I figured you might be over here. It's a holdup, huh?
Yeah, got away with a pack of money.
Well, let's go.
Where?
Well, after them. I'll saddle up and send out an alarm.
No, sir. You stay put, Mr. Deputy.
Well, Sheriff, you lost your mind?
No. But I'm well on my way to losing my daughter and what would have been a son. They're holding Wayne and Abby as hostages. We take out after them and we're as good as signing their death warrants.
In gaunt futility, the two men stare at each other. The woman they both love is in danger. And for the moment, they appear helpless to save her from it. Perhaps it's just as well they don't know the real truth about Wayne Prescott and the deadly choice that Abby will eventually have to make. I'll return shortly with Act Three. Sheriff and Hank are not totally aware of how deep the threat to Abby is. Wayne Prescott is totally unaware of a threat to him he had failed to foresee. As Abby and he, roped tightly to their saddle, ride through the chaparral towards the distant mountains, Slim and Bubba, their heads uncovered now, have fallen a little behind at Slim's signal.
We're gonna be rich now, Slim, huh?
Sure are, Bubba.
I like to have a pretty little gal like that to buy all them gewgaws and pretty dresses and all for.
She ain't your gal. She's Wayne's.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Wayne always got more than his share. Any job we pulled.
Because he has brains.
He ain't the only one. I've been doing some thinking.
Oh, you got brains too, Slim.
Yeah. Enough to know three don't divide even into 200,000.
It don't?
Nope. But two does. Just right on the nose.
I don't get you.
I'll explain it as soon as we get to the river and stop to water the horses.
They're heading for Mexico, or to get lost in the hills. From here to there, there ain't nothing higher than sagebrush, mesquite, and cactus. We follow, we couldn't get within 5 miles of them without being seen.
But if they get to the mountains, we'll lose them for sure. There's 100 draws, passes, gulches they could take. You can't track on rock.
Yeah, I know.
Sheriff, we just can't sit here and do nothing.
I know that, too.
Well, let me round up a posse while you study on how to go about it.
Hank, we don't need a posse. There's only two of them and two of us. We keep them busy enough. Abby and Wayne could get away.
Well, how do we catch up to them without being seen?
We're going to take Snake Arroyo.
Well, Snake Arroyo, that runs northwest.
To the river. Then we cross at Bates Ford. And the cottonwoods will provide a screen all the way to the hill.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They got to stop to water before they take to the hills.
And even though we're going all around Hell's Acre, we can easy double their time. They must have Abby and Wayne roped to the horses, and there's a weight of gold and silver as well as paper money. That's got to hold them back.
Yeah, with luck, we can beat them to the hills.
Yeah, well, we sure better. Or else we ain't liable to see either one again.
Untie the lady, brother. You can take the three horses and her down the river. Maybe she'd like to freshen up a bit while they water.
You can untie me, too.
Oh, not just right now. One at a time.
I'd just as soon stay here with Wayne.
Or do as you're told, lady. I'm running this.
You, better listen to him, Abby.
But I'm afraid that if he gets
me... Don't worry about me. I'll be all right.
Come on, little lady. Let's go with Bubba. Bubba don't figure to do anyone so pretty no harm.
Come on, Slim. Get me loose. You didn't have to tie me so tight.
You ready to reveal to your sweetheart what a bad guy you are?
No, what I want you to do is to let her go now.
Our prize hostage?
We bought enough time.
But we can't let her go now, Wayne. She knows who we are.
What'd you take the sacks off for?
Well, it's mighty hot and uncomfortable riding all smothered up. Besides, it'd make no difference, because Bub and me, we kind of decided we liked company. Any objections?
Yes.
Yes. Same little old brother. Always wants a lion's share. Only this time, you ain't exactly in a position to make demands now, are you?
You threatening me?
Oh, I'm just figuring to cut you down off your high horse so as you can learn something.
What?
That you ain't one whit better than either of your brothers. As you're going to find out once I tell a lady just who you are.
Fool critter gone and thrown me.
You all right, Sheriff? What happened?
Buster hit a gopher hole. Turned my ankle. I can't let it slow us up. Now, come on, help me mount. When we get to the river, I can soak it some. Come on, Hank. Time's a waste. Yeah.
Is it true what those men just told me?
Yes.
They're your brothers?
Yes.
You were one of the gunny sack gang Dad talked about? You robbed and killed?
It was a long time ago, Abby. I was a wild, crazy kid. We grew up like weeds. No parents, no home. Living like desert rats. We stole first to eat, then to outfit ourselves with horses, saddles, gear. Before I was out of my teens, we were guns for hire.
And now you're tied up, just like me. You're a prisoner just the same.
That wasn't the plan. After you were released, all I had to do was ask to be untied, I thought.
And now?
Where are my brothers? The way they have me tied to this
tree. I can't see.
They're talking to each other. They're glancing up this way. Looks like they're coming back.
Okay. Now, quick, Abby. In my boot. The right one. There's a knife. Can you get it out without them seeing?
Yes. The tree hides me. But with my hands tied together the way they are.
Pull the damn boot off. There. Now, shake the knife out and cut me free.
I have it. Oh, I don't want to cut you.
Don't worry about that. Now, hurry.
There.
Give me the knife, quick.
But cut me free.
No time for that. Here, stop them on the blind side of the tree so they don't see I'm loose.
But what am I supposed to
do? As I say.
Well, ma'am, did our little brother fess up to all his sins?
Yes. Please, the rope, it's hurting my hands. Circulation, it's so tight. Couldn't you just loosen it a bit?
Why, nah, we sure don't want to hurt a little bird like you.
Mama, watch yourself. You. Drop your gun, Slim. You can't hit me with Bubba between us. He took the shot you meant for me. I got Bubba's gun. Now drop yours.
I'll see you in hell first.
Then here's your ticket.
Why? You shot him in cold blood.
In self-defense. Watch out for him. Don't get too near.
Oh, Lord, how terrible.
Let me get that gun. Okay, Slim. Let's have a look at you.
It's too late. I might have known. For once, old Bubba and me, we thought we had you. But you was too smart. Like always.
You were gonna kill me, weren't you?
It's too much money to share. Trouble with all of us. We was always too hungry.
Is he dead?
Yeah. You heard him. Him or me.
Were you really brothers?
Yeah.
I don't know what to say. Can you... Will you cut me loose now?
That depends.
Well, what do you mean? We're going back, aren't we?
Nope.
Will you let me go?
I can't.
Why not? Please.
We'll talk about it later. There's too much to do now. We got to get going.
And leave them?
You can take Bubba's horse. I'll move her saddlebags from the pack horses to him. Mine to Slim's. They're best animals. And I'll tie Bubba and Slim to the saddles. Sink them in the river. It's as good a grave as any. The horses we can set free.
What is it, Sheriff? The ankle?
Yeah. It's killer.
Yeah, we can't stop now. Only a couple of miles to the hills.
Yeah, it's too late.
No, sir. We got plenty of daylight left yet. We could still beat them.
I didn't mean that. Hey, look. Across the river there.
Oh. Horses. Wild ones?
One of them's a pinto. Wasn't that what they had Abby up on? And Wayne on the chestnut with the blaze? By the Lord, if they've killed them.
I ain't gonna believe that till I see it.
You ride on, son. Don't hold up for me. I'll follow on as best as I can.
Can't we stop? So tired, I'd fall off if I wasn't roped on.
Hang on. We're almost into the stretch.
It's so dark. Can't see where we're going.
I can. The moon will be up soon.
We've taken so many jigs and jags, so many draws and passes. No one could find us now.
And I aim to make certain nobody does. You just sit. I'll lead us where we're heading.
My body, yes.
Well, we made it. That's the Rio Grande. On the other side, Mexico.
You're going with it?
We're going ahead with it.
Not me.
Abby, honey, we're not going to stay in Mexico. We'll work west and cross the border again to Arizona where nobody knows us. We can start a whole new life and live like a king and queen with all that money.
Well, we could have stayed home and had it all just the same. Oh, why, Wayne? Why?
Because I was tired of waiting. Would have taken years till the cattle thing started to bring back the money, and I wanted it now. Now! You have to understand what drives me, what money says to me, what power it means to me. Ever since the colonel made me over into a banker, and I've had to handle it, I've been sick. Sick inside for the want of it. For it to be mine. Now, you coming with me?
I've already answered that. No.
You know what it means if you don't. I can't leave you alive to set the law on my heels.
I know that.
Well, then, let's get it over with fast. Turn around. I'm giving you one last chance.
No.
You're giving me no choice.
You all right, Abby?
Yes. Hank?
I'll be right down.
How come you could track us?
You can thank Abby for that. Even a tenderfoot could have followed your trail.
How?
Oh, it wasn't thanks to me. It was thanks to the money. When we started through the gap, just as it was getting dark, and all your attention was on finding your way.
Yeah.
I dug into the saddlebags hanging before the pommel on Bubba's horse. And it was all paper money. Every time we took a turn or branch, I just dropped some out.
The joke's on me, all right. I thought this money was buying me all I wanted out of life. Instead, all it bought for me was death.
A nice story, but a just one. Poetic justice, wouldn't you say? That a man's greed for money paved the way to his own well-deserved death. I'll be back shortly. Chalmers never did make his fortune in cattle, for his old wound carried him away before he could learn the truth about a young man he loved as strongly as his sons. The money was returned to them in the East. Abigail Benson returned to Crystal City. She's Mrs. Hank Price now, and Hank is sheriff in her father's place. Money can't buy happiness, of course, but in this case, it pointed the way to the deserving. You can't ask for a better ending than that. Our cast included Bob Caliban, Robert Dryden, Russell Horton, Marion Seldes, and Ralph Bell. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
She disposed of an unwanted child and kept it a secret.
Oh?
Some years later, after she was happily married and had a little girl of her own, she was out strolling through these gardens one day when she met an absolutely enchanting young girl, just about her daughter's age. They all hit it off very well, and soon the three became friends. The only thing was that they couldn't ever figure out where this enchanting child lived or who were her parents. And this began to worry the young mistress of Ling, until one day, her daughter disappeared and was never found or seen again.
Well, I don't understand.
Don't you? The mother did. She had seen the ghost of Ling, her daughter's little friend. The ghost was the illegitimate child she'd killed. Only she didn't know till afterward.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, brewers of Budweiser.
This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.